Good morning. I have already made videos for qualitative quantitative translation, paragraph argument short answer, and experimental design questions. This is about the generic short answer type of question for AP Physics exams. According to the AP Physics 1 course and exam description, 2 out of the 5 free response questions on the exam will be this generic short answer question type. And even though 40% of the free response questions will be short answer, the course and exam description only has, as far as I can tell, the following to say about short answer questions. Billy?
Flippin' physics.
The 2 short answer questions focus on practices and learning objectives not focused on in the other question types. Well, that's not very helpful.
All that tells us is that short answer questions cover everything not covered in the qualitative quantitative translation, paragraph argument short answer, and experimental design questions.
Right.
Agreed. So in order to figure out what short answer questions really are, let's look at the 10 short answer questions which are in the publicly released AP Physics 1 exams from 2015 to 2019. When you go through those 10 short answer questions, you will discover that a full 5 of them are about topics which, in December of 2020, were removed from the AP Physics 1 curriculum. That's right. 50% of the publicly released AP Physics 1 short answer questions are about physics topics which are no longer a part of the AP Physics 1 curriculum. That means we only have 5 short answer free response questions to analyze to understand what short answer questions for AP Physics 1 are. 1 free response question from each year. I already have detailed solution videos for each of these free response questions, and each of those solution videos also includes suggestions on how to score better on the exam. Therefore, I think it will be useful here to look at all 5 of them in a general sense to find out what short answer questions are. The 5 free response questions we are going to analyze are 2015 number 1, 2016 number 1, 2017 number 4, 2018 number 1, and 2019 number 1. Each short answer question is worth 7 points. That means there are a total of 35 points represented by these free response questions. 3 out of the 5 free response questions, 2015 number 1, 2016 number 1, and 2018 number 1, each have a free body diagram, which is worth 2 points. That means 6 out of 35 points, or roughly 17% of all the points available in these 5 free response questions, come from simply drawing free body diagrams correctly. And 1 of these free body diagrams, 2018 number 1, only had 1 force in it, even though it was worth 2 points. Please take your free body diagrams seriously. Actually, let's look at 1 free body diagram specifically. Bobby, please read from the 2015 AP Physics 1 exam question number 1 through part A.
2 blocks are connected by a string of negligible mass that passes over massless pulleys that turn with negligible friction as shown in the figure. The mass M2 of block 2 is greater than the mass M1 of block 1. The blocks are released from rest. Part A. The dots represent the 2 blocks. Draw free body diagrams showing and labeling the forces, not components, exerted on each block. Draw the relative lengths of all vectors to reflect the relative magnitudes of all the forces.
Thank you, Bobby. Bo, please draw the free body diagrams.
Sure. Well, both blocks have a force of gravity acting down on them. Call them force of gravity 1 and force of gravity 2. Oh, and make the arrow for force of gravity 2 longer in length than the arrow for force of gravity 1, because mass 2 is greater than mass 1. And each mass has an upward force of tension acting on it, because both are being pulled upwards by a string. You can call them force of tension in 1 and force of tension 2. And because they are 2 ends of the same string, and both pulleys are massless and frictionless, those 2 forces of tension are equal in magnitude and need to have the same length arrow. That is the complete free body diagram.
Correct. A couple of quick things to point out. When you can, you should estimate the relative lengths of your free body diagram arrows. And you should never break forces into components on a free body diagram you are drawing as an answer in a problem on an AP exam. And please, definitely do not add forces to your free body diagrams simply because you do not feel there are enough forces in the diagram. And now, class, after you draw the free body diagram on a problem, typically, what should you do next?
Sum the break forces into components, redraw the free body diagram, and then sum the forces.
Right.
Yeah. If you need to, break forces into components and redraw the free body diagram somewhere other than where you drew it as an answer to the problem. And then you will likely use Newton's second law to sum the forces at least once. And sometimes you need to sum the forces twice in two different directions, which are perpendicular to one another. And then manipulate the equations to solve for a variable. You can see how we did that in the problem we were just talking about. We identified the positive direction, summed the forces in that positive direction, and solved for the acceleration of the two-block system. Summing the forces and manipulating equations to solve for a variable is what needs to be done on all three of the free response questions which ask you to draw the free body diagrams. Those solutions on the three free response questions are worth a total of 8 out of 35 points, or roughly 23% of all the points. In other words, drawing free body diagrams and summing the forces accounts for a total of 14 out of 35 points, or 40% of all the points on the five publicly released short answer questions. Again, I say, please take your free body diagrams seriously.
Absolutely.
Okay, sure.
Thanks. But the largest category of points on these five short answer free response questions is where they present you with a situation, ask you to answer a multiple choice question, and then justify or explain your answer. 15 out of 35 points, or roughly 43% of all the points, fit in this category. Every one of the five short answer free response questions has at least 2 out of 7 points for a multiple choice question and answer justification. In fact, all 7 points of AP Physics 1 2017 number 4 fit in this category. And several free response questions have a part worth only 1 point which fits in this category, which means what really matters for these is your justification or explanation, not the multiple choice answer itself. Many of these questions make a change to the situation first presented and then ask you a multiple choice question about how a variable will change and ask you to justify your answer. For example, Bo, please read part C of the free response question we've been looking at.
Block 3 of mass M3 is added to the system as shown. There is no friction between block 3 and the table. Part C indicate whether the magnitude of the acceleration of block 2 is now larger, smaller, or the same as the original 2-block system. Explain how you arrived at your answer.
Notice how they have changed the original physical situation and asked you to answer a multiple choice question about how a variable changes. In this case, they have added a block and asked you how the acceleration of block 2 will change with the addition of that third block. And again, the most important part is where you explain how you arrive at your answer. Please realize that. These questions are really about you using words to explain the physics behind your reasoning to answer the multiple choice questions. The last category I identify is the 5 points from Part A of AP Physics 1 2019 number 1. Here, they present you with a situation of two objects which collide and ask you to graph the speed of the center of mass of the system as a function of time. Your entire answer to Part A is worth 5 points, is only the lines you draw on the 5 parts of the graph. No explanation necessary. 5 out of 35 points, or roughly 14% of all the points on these 5 short answer questions, are for drawing a graph with no explanation necessary. So please realize, the College Board may throw something completely different at you, and you need to not get discombobulated by that.
Discombobulated?
Yes. Do not get discombobulated by a type of question you have never seen before on an AP exam. Honestly, if I were writing the exam, I would try to present you with something new to test your understanding of the physics rather than pattern recognition of past exams.
Yep, he would do that.
Yeah.
Lastly, there is a complete lack of numbers in all five of these short answer free response questions. Everything is free body diagrams, setting up equations, variable manipulations, graphs, and understanding and explaining how variables will be affected by changes in the physical situations presented. Whenever you are manipulating equations, you are manipulating variables, not numbers. As I have said so many times before, you need to let go of your numbers dependency. Also, if you want to see the specifics of how I categorized the different parts of the five short answer free response questions, I put those in the lecture notes on my website. Link in the description. All right. That is what I have to say about short answer questions on the AP Physics exams. Best of luck on the exams. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.